A mouse is highly recommended in order to take full advantage of Windows' powerful graphical environment. No, no, not that kind of mouse. I'm referring to the one that has little buttons on it and a tail that attaches to the computer.
I would advise you not to watch this video if you're eating. I was wondering why the scroll wheel on my mouse wasn't working so well anymore. Yeah, this could be the reason why. This is what happens when you use a mouse for about 15 years without opening it up to clean the scroll wheel. So this is a lesson that even if you have an optical mouse and you don't have to worry about cleaning a roller ball, eventually you will have to clean the scroll wheel. An entire thing was just caked with dust. There was even some caked in the bottom here, so I just took out the circuit board. I only need one screw to take apart this whole mouse. It wasn't difficult at all to take apart. And I prepared some warm soapy water, so I'm just gonna dunk the whole thing in. I took out the electronics, so this isn't gonna hurt anything. This does not appear to have any electronic parts in it, so I'm just gonna dunk that in as well. I'm gonna clean the mouse. So I'll let this soak for a while and then rub off any remaining dirt and put it back together. Should be good for another 15 years. And as for the circuit board, I have my official IBM typewriter brush to clean it. Just brush off the dust, get it away from the optical sensors. Those are the little things here that read the movement of the roller ball. You have an infrared LED and an infrared sensor for the horizontal and vertical movement, and that's what reads the movement of the mouse. And looks like there's another pair here for the scroll wheel. You can see a little LED there. So, it's not too dirty. This was a compact mouse made by Logitech, so it has their logo on the circuit board. And that's it for the electronics. The mouse is looking much better after I let it soak for about half an hour and then rinsed it off. I'm just gonna let it air dry for a little bit. The scroll wheel further disassembled into a couple other parts here, including these two little spring things. Shouldn't be too hard to figure out how it goes back together. And if need be, I can take apart this one to serve as a guide. Although I'm afraid when I do, I'll see also how dirty this one is inside. The only thing else I needed to do was clean the cable, but some acetone and a paper towel took care of that. Still has a little bit of dirt on it, but it's much, much better than it was. So I did have to take the other one apart to remember how to put back together the scroll wheel. And this whole assembly just sits in this little channel here. And this spring is what gives it the clickiness. Otherwise it would just sit all the way down. That spring is what provides the tension to let you click on the scroll wheel, which I bet most people don't even know they can do. And the part that makes the scroll wheel click as you turn it, if I hold it at just the right angle, you can see there's little notches on the inside of the scroll wheel, and it rubs against this metal piece here, and as you move it, that's what makes it click. So that's the scroll wheel, and it is an optical sensor. It measures how many times the light is blocked by one of those little spokes as you move it, and that's what makes it count how much you turn it. So it's time to reassemble. Circuit board just sits into place. And this cable goes between the button switch and the little support for the scroll wheel, and then it just goes through this little notch in the case. So that's how that goes. And we take our scroll wheel, you gotta put this little spring on like that. You can see one hook is facing inwards, and then towards the back is facing outwards. And we should be able to just drop it down. And there you can see the little spring providing the tension to click on the wheel. Once you put this together, it will sort of hold everything in place. So it's quite ingenious how they hold everything together just with one screw the bottom here, and everything else is just a press fit. And you can see that other spring the way it goes. There's a little hole right there where you have to stick it in, and then it, as I showed earlier, it rubs against the top of this part here to provide the clickiness as you move your scroll wheel. So now we should be able to just snap the cover in place. Little hooks on the top here. You gotta kind of hook that end in first. It's a little tricky. And it just sort of pops together. And we just put our ball in. And the retaining thing. There we go. Now just that one screw. And that's it. Just screw it in.
No, I do not have a special offer on spicy prawn balls. This is not the Chinese takeaway. And will you please get off my white slimline telephone with last number redial?
And this may not be true of all computers, but at least with this former Compaq, which I put in a InWin small form factor case, I have no problem hot swapping the PS2 mouse. So we can just unplug this one I put in as a substitute and plug in this one, our new restored mouse. And we're good to go. Let's see if the scrolling works. Let's go to Windows. Yep, scrolling is working. I noticed before, as I was scrolling slowly, it would ignore my scrolling. I had to scroll quickly in order to get it to respond. But now, even just one notch at a time, it's working fine. So that's how you restore your PS2 mouse after 15 years of service and get it ready for another 15 years. And like I mentioned, even with a newfangled optical mouse where you don't have to worry about taking out and cleaning the roller mechanism, you will still eventually need to clean the scroll wheel because it will eventually build up with dust, just like the one I showed.